Selling your home is stressful enough, but selling in the age of social distancing may feel like a nightmare. But it doesn't have to be. Buyers are coming back to the market, and sellers should be in a good position given how very little supply there is now for sale. There are, however, some new strategies to use in order to keep your process safe and sane. First, staging your home to sell has never been more important, even if you're not letting people in. You have to double down on every good practice you had pre-quarantine and make sure the house is even more prepared for virtual visits than it would be for actual visits. So don't skimp. Resist the urge to save on staging and perhaps step it up, because you will need that compelling virtual tour. Agents are using the newest 3D technology, some that allow buyers to move through the home on their own. Make sure the agent you choose has the very latest. Also, make sure your agent is willing to do live virtual tours.
Hi, Nancy and John.
That is, walk around the home in a live chat with potential buyers on a tablet or smartphone. And not just Facebook live showings either. Nobody wants to sit through that.
Shirley, what's going on? Evelyn, how's it going?
It has to be private enough for the buyer to join in without feeling exposed. If they do a group showing, make sure buyers can participate easily and have the agent use an assistant to read comments and make notes of questions. If possible, and it may not be, move out of the house before you put it on the market. An empty house is far easier to show these days because buyers can do self-showings. Several companies now offer smart lock boxes with one-time codes to let buyers access the home through their smartphones. You can leave very minimal furniture to stage a bit, but items that are unlikely to be stolen. If you are allowing people into the home while you're living there, make sure you vet all buyers carefully. You don't need neighbors or other snoopers in a time like this. Make sure the buyers are serious. And finally, don't overprice it. Buyers may have little to choose from, but they're also not desperate. With the economy in free fall, they're more likely to be looking for a bargain than willing to pay a premium. I'm Diana Olick, CNBC.